it was all about, you know, making these characters into humans and you know, 3D humans, 360 degree angles on the perspectives and on the approach of these characters, because you know it's a banlieue movie, like a ghetto movie. And I think nowadays we also, especially because now, you know, for example, rap music and stuff, it's became pop culture. And so there's also a glorification going on of ghetto life. And there's a very strange duality in that phenomenon, because there's a glorification of violence, there's a glorification of whatnot, and because it feeds a certain industry, and that industry benefits a lot from it.
It's not the good guys and the bad guys. It starts with a simple drawing between the cops and the gangsters and stuff, and finally, the more you spend time with the characters and the more you go through the movie, the more complicated it is, like in the life itself.
When I was preparing the writing, meeting drug dealers and policemen, I realized how the two worlds were really entremêlés. Because to fight against trafficking, drug trafficking, you have to know the drug dealers, you have to talk with them, you have to protect some to catch others.